All right. Hello, hello, everyone.
Hello.
Hello, friends.
All right, we are all good. You may notice that we do not have a picture today. The reason being that I have hurt my back, so it hurts to sit down in the chair that I usually sit in. So I'm standing tonight, and I cannot figure out a good camera angle so that you're not looking at my stomach. So for the next
join
couple,
the faceless collective.
Exactly. So possibly for the next couple of streams, we'll see if the video ever comes back. This is like weirdly freeing. I can do whatever the hell I want to.
You're right though.
All right. So recap, and thank you for the well wishes. Edgeworth and Franziska bullied Larry and each other over Larry's testimony, from which we proposed that Elise was killed near the bridge where her crystal fell. Larry wasted time drawing a sketch of her flying over the burning bridge after waking up, and someone moved the body to the courtyard. And Iris won't break her psyche locks about her actions that night until she's sure Maya is safe. All she's admitting to is using the snowmobile and not being a murderer. Yeah, we basically got nothing done last time other than remove some possibilities and watch the world's most exhausting sibling squabble. Despite her rapid fire whipping, I can confirm that Franziska's whip count went from 49 to 60 at the very end. And she said, I demand satisfaction while she was killing Larry. Unfortunately, I must have missed that, but
we were distracted by trying to figure out how many freaking whips.
Yeah, listen, the whip count got out of hand last time, so
we got to like two and then just like gave up.
For real.
All right. Well, I think we're back to Phoenix. So shall we ahead and get started?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. I will close the chat so you guys can see.
February 9th, 3:43 a.m. Hottie clinic intensive care. Hottie. I'm still up at this hour, reading through the trial record of a certain case. First case my mentor, Mia Fey, had ever handled in a court of law. A horrifying truth that I refuse to accept is holding me hostage here within its pages.
Okay, Nick.
Oh shit, down. It's her. Dahlia. My love. Well, my ex-love who tried to poison me, but we're not going to talk about that. We're not going to address it. We're going to pretend it didn't happen. What I have read, I don't want to believe. Mostly because we had a great makeout session and I refuse.
Oh my god.
What is written here? This isn't the Dahlia I knew.
I feel compelled to ask, are straight people okay?
I don't think they are.
No. People are definitely not okay. After falling into Eagle River, I was somehow miraculously saved. But I ended up catching a cold that seemed to knock me around the world and back. I feel dizzy, my ears are ringing, my throat burns, and my head is on fire.
And he decided to read a case file.
Yeah, because that's what I do when I'm at the hospital.
Work.
But I will recover. I have to recover by this afternoon, or else. I have to meet with the most ill-tempered witness imaginable. But I know that he will be able to help me with him. Somehow. Wow, nobody has faith in Larry. Nobody,
no,
absolutely.
Of course not.
February 9th, 2:43 p.m. Dusky, not dusty, bridge. Right, are you sure you're well enough to be doing this? You still look a little green in the face.
Or maybe Viridian in artist speak.
Oh no, he adopted his words. Actually, my fever has gone down quite a bit.
How's your temperature now?
Only 102.2 degrees. Nothing to worry about.
I'm pretty sure that's still something to worry about, but...
Anyway, I read today's trial record. Weren't bad, Edgeworth. Pretty impressive, despite the circumstances. We're not in the clear yet. Anyway, I can't believe I complimented you. The main point of contention tomorrow is going to be the murder weapon. Yeah! In the end, the Shichishido did not deliver the deadly blow.
And I still have to ask, like, how the hell did the forensics department miss that?
Yeah.
I don't think anyone here is doing their jobs except for these two.
What the hell?
Which means there must be another sword hiding out there that we don't know about. Another sword, huh?
Don't you worry about a thing, pal. I don't know why I went southern there. I'll dig up the murder weapon myself, or I'll eat my coat. And it is not nutritious after this many years, let me just tell you.
Thanks again, Edgeworth. I'll handle things from here. That is probably not for the best. Or wait, it is. Oh, it is. Never mind, it is for the best. I lied. See, I was tricking you. I did that to the judge the other day, but actually, I was thinking about paying the old precinct a little visit. There's something I want to look into. And that is? Our client's background, naturally. Come on, do your job right.
You mean Iris, sir?
I have the feeling that we've met before. Just can't put my finger on it. All I want is confirmation. One way or the other. And since I probably won't be getting that from you, I'm sorry, Edgeworth. I bet you I do right. Take care! Bye. Ta-ta, whatever.
Guess I should get moving too!
Why? Do you need to be somewhere?
No, but I only play the plucky sidekick to one prosecutor, turn defense attorney, turn back to prosecutor. Yeah, I gotta get to work on this bridge, pal. I'm rigging something up so we can get across to the other side. Oh yeah, that's right, I forgot he's a little, inventor.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah. And also, is Maya still over there?
Yeah.
Ah, that's right! Maya's still stuck over at the inner temple!
Has someone airlifted, like, burgers down?
Yeah.
Like, can we...
Can she get some Uber Eats?
Yeah, like, if they throw McDonald's down from the helicopter, is there anything technically bad about that? Just asking for a friend. But don't you worry, pal. Soon as it's all set, you'll be the first to know. Well, probably the second, because I'll probably call Mr. Edgeworth first and say, hey, guess what, Mr. Edgeworth, I did something, and he won't be impressed, but that's okay. You'll be second.
I delivered McDonald's, sir, and then he'll tell me to go work at McDonald's.
And then he'll cut my pay.
No. Thank you, Gumshoe.
No problem, Belle. Just a... Try not to give me that cough of yours, okay? All right, I am off. The three steps that you can see to the bridge.
Hang in there, Maya. We'll get you out, I promise, and get you some McDonald's. In the meantime, I've got to continue collecting evidence.
See, the way that I imagined that went down was literally, he just fucking went, okay, bye, and then turned around.
February 9th, Heavenly Hall.
I mean, considering how we've done some of these cross-examinations with people, like, where we've just sat here and asked about everything we had in our possession, I'm sure that's what some people just do at this point when they see us.
Oh yeah, for sure. Looks like no one's here. Larry! Larry! I was sure he'd be hiding here. Guess I'll try again later.
But why is the door closed?
Larry's! Look at this graffiti scrawled right on the front of the shack. At least he managed to get a pretty good likeness. When I really think about it, I guess art kinda suits him. He's weird and weird. He's just weird, but I mean, his very existence is an art of sorts. What is this line? What is this line?
It's called How Much Can We Bully Larry?
It's the Bully Larry. February 9th, Hazakura Temple, main gate.
Oh, I think we found Larry.
Yeah, there he is.
I'm going to take, yeah, I was going to say, I'll take it regardless since I have not talked. Come on, please. It's for art's sake, I swear.
Only one guy I know who could be this persistent and high strung.
Talking about the heroine here. The heroine in my book. It'll make you famous.
Oh, why would you do this?
Oh, shit.
Enough! A fool's fool's fool's... Oh my god, let me try that again.
Oh, this is gummy.
Okay, I got this. A fool's fool fools fools who foolishly accept the foolishness of a fool's fool. Wouldn't you agree, Phoenix Wright?
No.
Huh? Me? Dude, I just got here.
Please don't get her riled up again. I don't know how many times I can say fool.
I know you're-
Your reflexes and mine need to shape up.
My brain's frying like a sunny side up and you want to grill me over a name?
Franzi, you can't do that. Oh no, we're gonna get our ass kicked.
Called her Franzi.
Even as we speak, Nick's on the brink of death. Or so the story knows. No, or so I'm told.
Whip a dead horse. Isn't that one of your American sayings?
What? But I'm Japanese. No, it's not. And I'm not on the brink of anything.
Come on, Nick. Tell her, would you? Hold on. Frickety frick frack is happening. Tell her she needs to model for my new picture book, Franzi's Whippity Whip Trip.
Oh! You will die.
Before you ask me to model, learn to give at least semi-coherent testimony.
Canonically, it's implied that Larry eventually succeeds in getting Franziska to let him make a book about her. Oh, shit. Also, we're at 64, damn! And before that, you will have to learn how to live a semi-coherent life, Larry.
I don't care what anyone says. I'm telling you the truth, I saw what I saw. He flew, I'm telling you. Whoosh. Just like that dude with the red underwear.
Superman?
Don't think I'm gonna forgive you guys when you come crawling back to apologize.
Oh, off he goes.
It's amazing how little has changed with you in the past year, Phoenix Wright. Oh, this is gonna be a fun questioning.
Thank you? Have you been in Germany all this time?
That's right. Extending my perfect wind record. Naturally.
Oh, joy. Sounds like she hasn't changed a bit. I feel like she got worse. Has it really been a year since we first met?
I am Franziska von Karma, the prodigy.
I see.
I gave up a promising career in Germany and came to this country for one sole reason. Revenge.
Didn't get.
Didn't. Too bad. Franziska was born and raised in Germany and became a prosecutor at the age of 13.
How is that legal?
Man, what was I doing when I was 13?
I mean, I'd like to point out, we found out that Manfred von Karma was a murderer, so he could have broken other laws too, including child labor. So.
Yeah. Oh no! Her father was a legendary prosecutor, Manfred von Karma. He had a perfect win record for 40 long years, but now he's gone from this world. Not my fault. Definitely not my fault. Don't tell me you still hold a grudge against me because of what happened to your father.
I forgot how much we like to shove it in her face that we're the reason her father is dead. Phoenix Wright, you will fall before me. This, I promise. But it will be for my sake, not my father's. Are we clear?
Yes, ma'am. Crystal. Mm.
In truth, I was shocked. I came back to America with the intention of defeating you, and instead, it was my little brother who was leading the defense.
Edgeworth. Come to think of it. Edgeworth was pulled into being a prosecutor by Manfred von Karma as well.
Miles Edgeworth told me something very interesting, you know. He said that this case has a special significance to you.
Don't lie to him, he's a liar. No, don't listen to him. No. Because it does.
And that's precisely why I'm here. Your personal involvement will make crushing you into teensy-weensy pieces all the better.
Okay. Probably the fever, but, she's so openly hostile that it's almost kind of cute.
Why?
She's gonna murder you.
No! No! Phoenix, no! Don't touch fire! What are you doing?
No smirking!
No whipping the stick!
That foolish fool doing such a foolish favor for such a foolishly foolish fool! She needs to stop going on these rants, like, I have to do them all in one breath. Make no mistake, Phoenix Wright. I came here for one thing, and one thing only. To pulverize you.
I have a fever. Can I be excused? It's not like I thought you were here to bring me some cold killer X, you know?
I mean, the cold killer X from the previous trial was poisoned, so... I went over the whole case on the... I can read. I went over the whole case file on the flight over.
You read the whole thing?
Yes. Every last word of every last sentence of every last paragraph. All the ridiculous things you did made it a very interesting read, you know. Hey. Attempting to cross a burning bridge? Did you even consider the dangers?
No.
No.
No thought head empty.
Yeah, no thought head empty. I was thinking of Maya, bitch. Anyway, the only thought in my mind was I have to get across.
A fool who doesn't think is more foolish than a fool who foolishly thinks.
Yoshi said he'd let me know once the bridge was repaired. Maya, she's gonna be okay. I just know it, as long as we have McDonald's. Plus, I need to ask her about what really happened at the Inner Temple that night.
Weird flex, but okay. Is there anything interesting that I should ask her about?
No, we're not gonna... That's gonna go down very, very bad.
Hi, would you like to talk about the sketch again? She does not want to talk about the
sketch again. No, should we get the ripped for asking about the sketch? Oh damn.
You wanna talk about any of these people? No. Doesn't wanna talk about Maya.
So technically that's 66 whipped.
We're about to get whipped more, because I wanted to know about some people.
Okay. Are we counting these?
I don't know if we're counting these or not. I don't know that she's going to talk to me, but I have to try anyways. You wanna talk about Larry?
Nah. I don't think there's anything, but, you know, if you want to drive up the whip count, go ahead.
Yeah.
Wait, are you whipping me for fun? Nah.
Maybe.
Ma'am, I have a fever.
February that sounds 9th. Like a you problem.
As a current sample, main hall, ouchie. Oh, no.
Okay, I think the only person we haven't talked to who's not Pearl, who's missing, or Maya, who's in the thing, is Sister Bikini?
Yeah, I'm gonna guess it's me, and I guess... Ma!
That was a great line to leave. That was one long sigh.
Would you like to retry that?
insert noise here.
I'm like, pretty happy with my sister.
Sister Bikini?
my. How? I didn't know you were here. How are you doing?
You don't have to pretend to be in a good mood for my sake.
I am frozen. There we go. I suppose I've made a terrible mess of things, haven't I? I let Mystic Elise die, and then there's Iris as well. Yeah, you're horrible.
And, oh, you're cool. And she left Maya over in the inner temple, so...
Yeah. Mystic Elise, now that I think about it...
There's an acolyte stuck at the inner temple. You know, she's our friend. We came with her, remember? And that poor little girl has gone missing, too.
I want to know why the 8-year-old going missing is not more of an issue.
Yeah, right.
Like, did anyone file a missing person report? Is the police looking for her? Like, guys, this is a child in the cold snow. Come on. I mean, I know Maya's a big priority, but where's the 8-year-old? That little girl? You don't mean Pearls, do you?
Yes, I'm afraid I do. She hasn't been seen since the morning after the incident.
Pearls, she's missing? Why didn't anyone tell me about this? Even though I was unconscious.
We aren't afraid for Pearl's safety because she can survive anything, but whoever took her away is probably dying in pain right now.
I mean, not wrong.
You're right.
If any, like, the thing is that of any of the characters getting lost in the snow or something, I feel like Pearl is the most likely to survive.
Yeah.
Pearl's is OP, guys. OP.
It must be getting old. I must be getting old, excuse me. Read. I think I've seriously lost faith in myself.
Are you talking about your performance in the trial today?
Yeah, you suck. Yeah, you believe me, don't you? I'm not a liar. I never lie.
About that.
But I know what I saw. I saw Iris pull the sword from Mystic Elise's body that night. Certain of it, at least I was until this morning.
Oh, so you're not certain of it. I don't see any psyche locks, so she must be telling the truth.
She believes it's the truth.
Right, so why are you so unsure of yourself all of a sudden? Sus.
You know that artist who testified after me?
Unfortunately.
Unfortunately, yes.
I saw Iris flying, her white hood fluttering. I felt like I might start flying myself, because I was on drugs.
Oh yeah, we talked about it. It's like, is he doing meth?
When I saw that man testify so fervently about something so impossible, I started to wonder if I had acted just like him when I was on the witness stand.
I wouldn't take that guy too seriously. I've known him for years. He's an artist, but all he draws is trouble and nothing else. If both Bikini and Larry are telling the truth, that can only mean one thing. They both didn't see what they think they saw. On the night of the incident, you met Iris at the Inner Temple, is that correct?
That's right. I'm sure it was Iris.
But Iris claims she was in the... Iris claims she was in her room in Hazakura Temple.
I knew I shouldn't have come back here that night.
But because you did, Maya stuck all by herself in the Inner Temple.
Well, we are not pulling our punches there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm so sorry. Sorry's not good enough. She's gonna frickin' die of frostbite.
Yeah, how dare you?
I'd like to point out, if Sister Bikini was over there, the bridge would still be out, so they'd both die of frostbite.
Yeah. Details.
Anyway, I'm having to shake the stick at. Winter is especially bad.
I'll bet. The training hall looks like it's about to fall down any second.
Sorry, my connection's not super great. Uh-oh. So, I apologize. Eagle Mountain has always been prone to earthquakes, just so you know.
Not making me feel better. Earthquake!
So Edgeworth is gonna have a real fun time here, I'm hearing.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I would be surprised if the next big one levels the training hall.
We gotta get Maya out of there fast!
But still, there's really no need to worry.
Uh-huh.
That area on the other side of Dusky Bridge is isolated like an island.
It's like an island. How so?
Well, the only thing on that side of the bridge is the Inner Temple. No one lives out there, and it's surrounded on all sides by the river or the forest.
I see.
So a criminal would be trapped, so should they choose to flee in that direction? As long as the bridge is out of commission, he or she... Frickin' they is right there. This is one of my biggest pet peeves, is whenever, first of all, they is right there. We should just use it. He or she, or, like, that's a waste of time.
It is.
But sorry, I wonder how many of us have, peeves. Like, trauma from English class.
Yeah. Me. Literally me.
Like, it took me years to get over seeing they and not, like, wanting to correct he or she in there, because that's what you had to do for essays. But you are correct. Please, just use they. As a linguist, I can confirm singular they has been around for a while.
Anyway, sorry, I'm going to step off that soapbox before I get more riled up about it.
That means Maya... That means Maya could be stuck out there with the murderer and with no way to escape either.
Oh dear. Yes, I suppose it does.
Please come to get that prisoner faster.
I mean, she's been there for like 48 hours with one now. Like, if they kill her, she's already dead.
Yep. I'm curious about a few things, if you don't mind answering some questions.
Oh, hell yeah. My language teacher agreed with me that he or she answer on the homework was outdated and it should have been they.
Nice.
Thank God. We're so excited about your essay.
Look, if you ever find someone who disagrees, like, have them come talk to me.
No.
Oh, hell yeah. We'll gang up on time and we'll have a nice chat.
Do you need to know my measurements for your investigation or something?
No.
No. No. No. No. No. We don't. I want to know a little more about the victim, Miss Elise Donim.
I'm afraid I don't know her waist size, but her bust size for that matter. Or her bust size.
So you know her hip and inseam?
Honestly, I would be surprised if she knew her bust size.
No, no. I'm wondering why she came to stay in a place like this to begin with. I mean, she told us herself that she wasn't here for spiritual training.
My, my, my. You make it sound like this place is some sort of dump, Mr. Wright.
I never said that, ma'am.
Mystic Elise was here to soak up the natural beauty of Eagle Mountain, if you must know.
There, you did it again, Sister Bikini. I notice you always refer to Miss Donim as Mystic Elise.
Oh?
Yes, now, why is that? After all, she's not here as an acolyte.
We address all our visitors as mystic. It makes their experience feel authentic.
We are Mystic Phoenix.
I am Mystic Phoenix, then. Ha! Feels so powerful.
And anyway, she's older than me. You must respect your elders, you know. What is this woman? I mean, it's probably the nun outfit, but I just think of her as, like, this little lady.
Yeah. Well, I mean, she is, though. Like, how do you know that? How can you say for sure that she's older than you?
I mean, she's 48.
And she's 48, and how old is...
We don't know how old Elise is.
Oh. A mystery.
It is a mystery. We also don't know how old Godot is, so... And everyone else is a baby on this case. Oh, Pearl is 9! So she had her birthday. I'm sorry, Pearly. I didn't mean...
She had her birthday! Oh!
Happy late birthday, Pearly!
Happy birthday!
Oh, shit. Here we go.
Oh, yeah, and clearly, you know, something what we probably should be focusing on, not Pearl having a birthday, but...
Huh.
Yeah.
Seems Miss Elise Onim was an ordinary visitor after all. And there's Pearl's. She was with Miss Onim on the evening of the murder, and now she's vanished. So that means Pearl's killed Miss No, it's all got to be connected somehow.
She said Mystic Maya and Mr. Neck weren't meant to be together, and that was the end.
Killed her. Why did Pearls have to get mixed up in all this mess?
Please, Mr. Wright, I know you're worried, but try to keep it together.
No, you can't make me. I mean, oh man. My head's throbbing so bad it's killing me. Pearls, she was with Miss Donim on the night of the murder, remember?
Yes, but I have a temple to run, you know? I was busy preparing for the training. I didn't see the little darling even once after we'd finished eating dinner.
The murder, it didn't take place right in front of her innocent eyes, did it? Did we just traumatize her?
According to the detective, she hasn't turned up at her home either.
She just decided to walk back to Kudane Village.
It's fine. Yeah. Come on, keep calm. There's one place left where Pearls could be. She just has to be there. Come on, Gumshoe. Tell me you're all done with the repair soon.
Alright. We're gonna see what she needs. I don't think we can break her psyche lock, but...
we can try our best!
We can see what we got.
Mr. Mucchini, the truth is becoming increasingly clear to me. I'm convinced that Miss Elise Donim had a special significance to this temple. As to why she had a special significance, I believe it has to do with her true identity.
What on earth are you talking about? She was... Miss Elise was an author, just an author, of picture books.
Be honest. I had my suspicions almost immediately after I met her.
Suspicions?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I didn't have any evidence to support my theory, though.
Well, I don't think I do.
Well, now I do. This piece of evidence proves Miss Donim's true identity. Is it the scroll? I bet it's the scroll. Something tells me it's the scroll. I just had a galaxy brain moment, and I feel like it's the scroll.
I mean, I'd like to point out that the scroll does not prove her identity. It proves
but maybe
who
it
she
does.
It might prove who she is, but it doesn't prove that she is Misty Faye, right?
Yeah.
So we're going to back off for now, especially because that's the only piece of evidence we have around that.
I don't think I have enough evidence yet. I should investigate together. Shit!
Alright, let's take a look in the courtyard and see if anyone's there to chat.
Larry Sketch, her identity is the flying magician Max Galactica. February 9th, Hazakura Temple Courtyard. There's the blood. Where is Sister Bikini's witness? She witnessed the incident. Wow, it's hard to imagine she was lying on the stand, so maybe there are some clues that have yet to be found. Yet again, I have to be the detective and everything else. Shame. Wait a minute. Did y'all see that?
No.
I don't know if I'm right, but is that blood on that ladder?
I don't think so.
It's very uniform if it is.
Aww. Anyway.
Like, I assume that your screen that you're looking at is a little smaller than mine is. It's in very, square, strips.
Mm-hmm. Alright, I'll put a pin on that. They get quite a bit of snow up here on Eagle Mountain. Around here, skis aren't just for fun. The tools for getting around. Right. But the sled. Now that's gotta be for Bikini's own personal entertainment. Bet. That building up there is the main hall. It was where we were staying. It's just kind of funny because it was built on a very steep slope. you enter from the main gate side, these rooms above me are on the ground floor. Apparently, Miss Onim was staying in the corner room. Guess that's where she was pushed from that night.
Except for that doesn't make sense now if you think that she was in the inner temple when she died.
Right. The main gate's on the other side of the stone wall. The difference is in elevation is almost 10 feet. That's how steep the hillside is. And that's also the height the body fell from, according to the autopsy. Is it possible that Mr. Nim was pushed from the top of the wall?
The fuck was she doing on top of the wall, my dude?
Hardcore parkour. The cheat sheet. Can you imagine? That would suck. It's there in Mr. Kami's right hand. But it was proven in court today that it wasn't the murder weapon. Given the design, it must have been used for some pretty gruesome things in the past.
Probably not, actually, but...
Yeah, it's just there for decor. Miss Onim's staff. I definitely remember there being a crystal sphere attached to the staff. Guess Larry eventually found the sphere near the foot of the Dusky Bridge, but, what was it doing all the way out there? Oh, it's playing baseball. No. There are a few of these stone lanterns scattered around in the courtyard. Without the city glare to compete with, I imagine they would seem a lot brighter. Guess Sister Bikini must light them now, since Iris can't be there.
Well, yes, it's called being accused of murder.
Yeah.
I'm not really seeing anything new here.
That ladder is so weird to me. What if that little side thing is a handprint of blood? Okay. Anyway.
I'm not seeing anything new. We're gonna move on. Hello!
Oh no!
Hey!
Oh, that jarring, inconsiderately loud yell.
So this is where you've been! Keeping nice and warm, I see.
Detective, have you finished-
The bridge? Yeah, I did. I told you I'd let you know. I already called Mr. Edgeworth and he cut my pay again for some reason.
I think you should get a raise for, completing the bridge to help Maya, though. Anyway.
Well, then I'll come along with you and...
Sorry, ma'am. No unauthorized entry. Access is restricted to people involved in the case.
Oh, shit.
What was that? I'm involved, aren't I? You couldn't get much more involved than me.
Well, yeah, but that's not what I mean.
That was two whips.
It's been a while, Scruffy. It's Miss Karma.
1, 2, 3, 4. That was 4.
Oh, four. He's down.
Sister. Oh, wow.
Please leave the investigation to me.
My. Well, you certainly seem to have everything under control.
I am on your side. I won't do anything you don't want me to do.
So you work to pin the guilt on Iris.
What are you daydreaming about, Phoenix Wright?
1, 2, 3. Ow, that hurt. 4. Ow.
Silence! I, Franziska von Karma, will personally guide you through your investigation. So you will follow me.
Not seriously going to follow me around, is she?
Well, we now have a plucky female sidekick again.
Now we have 72 whips.
I was about to say that this one's more violent, but Maya's pretty violent.
Yeah. Look at the nice work, Edward. Gumshoe Edward. Did. Edward didn't do shit.
Just stared at himself. February 9th, Inner Temple Gate. things have certainly become a lot more hectic than before.
They must have commenced with the investigation. Oh! Mr. Nick!
Oh, snap! That voice!
Yay!
It's Pearls! Pearly!
Mr. Nick!
My child! So you were here ever since that night?
I was so lonely. I thought I was going to die. When I woke up in the morning and saw the dusky bridge was gone, I realized I was all alone.
It was all alone?
It must have been very trying for you, little girl. Ah! You're... I am Francisca von Karma, the prodigy. There's no need to worry now that I'm here. You're the prosecutor who was so mean to Mystic Maya last year.
Oh, shit.
Well, I don't like you. You're nothing but a little girl without your whip!
Oh, fuck. Savage.
Mystic Maya didn't do anything wrong, but you were so mean! I'll never forgive you!
Roasted.
Wow, it looks like Pearl's words are getting under her skin. Damn! Yeah, why are you whipping me? I didn't even say anything!
You didn't have to. The smile on your lips gave you away.
Anyway, Pearls? Weren't you with Maya?
Sorry, it's all my fault.
Huh? What are you talking about, Pearls?
I Mystic Maya!
Hey, wait, Pearls! Ah, oh, she just ran off.
Okay, bye.
Ow!
That was cruel, Phoenix Wright. To make a little girl cry like that is inexcusable.
You did it first.
She cries so easy.
What's that all about? Pearl's acting like that. It's giving me the creeps. I guess I better take another look around since I finally got a chance. Especially since something about this place seems different from 2 days ago.
I mean, considering the fact that the last time we looked at this place was months ago,
Yeah.
Phoenix Wright!
What? And would you stop calling me by my full name like that?
Was this once a prosperous port?
A port?
Yes. That metal hook is a mooring post for boats, you know. That thingy.
Oh, that. That's an anchor. For one of the wires that is used to hold up the bridge. I think the wire that was tied to this one probably snapped when the bridge burned down. I mean, there's no way there was ever a port all the way up here.
Don't get smart with me, Phoenix Wright!
But I didn't say anything!
You didn't have to.
Hey.
Nope, apparently I can get caught on that.
Oh no!
Oh no?
Did I miss something? The stream cut off for a while. No, we just got whipped.
We got whipped a lot.
It was just 2 more, though, I believe. I just got whipped twice.
Also, Pearl just roasted Franziska into oblivion.
Yeah, and then we paid for it. Because she can't whip a child. Look at all the Buddha statues lined up along this path.
Phoenix Wright, do you think this is how many siblings the head nun has?
Why do you ask? Why don't you ask her next time you see her?
You know what? I think I will.
Okay. And she'll probably slap you for prying into her private affairs. But go on. There's a weird smell coming from that incinerator. Door's also open, almost like it's begging me to look inside. Well, let's see what stunning clue is concealed in behind door number 1. Okay.
A dead body.
Huh? It's empty!
How naive of you, Phoenix Wright.
But It's a bit strange, don't you think? Franziska von Karma.
Gonna whip you again.
I feel it in my jellies, yeah. I seem to remember. There was snow on this incinerator the first time I saw it.
I don't even think we looked over at this part.
In other words, someone's been using it to burn something recently.
I legitimately don't remember us ever being on this part.
Like, yeah, here, I think we only looked at the other side because I didn't realize there was a scroll.
yeah.
Details. Listen, Phoenix Wright. It's impertinent to call people by their full name.
I was only copying you, so... Okay.
It's impertinent.
Okay. There's a little gate that leads into the garden. It says no entry on the sign, though.
Come now, Phoenix Wright. What are you doing? Let's go in. It's half open anyway. What harm could come of it?
This sign can't stop me because I can't read.
Exactly.
But it says no entry.
Don't you Americans enjoy doing whatever you like and then simply saying whatever?
That's got nothing to do with anything. Who told you that?
She's lived here, so.
It's called Ferris Bueller's Day Off. The sign says Inner Temple.
I don't know how you're reading it, but it's incomprehensible to me.
Actually, I can't read it either.
Feigning comprehension isn't a very good habit to have, Phoenix, right?
He looks really happy to finally caught me on something.
She's a 19-year-old. She wants to catch you on just about everything. This must be the door that leads to the inner temple, where Maya Fey was training on the night of the murder.
Yes, there's a solitary room. They're called the training hall.
You could do with some training yourself, Phoenix, right?
Shut up.
Ow!
You're completely out of shape.
I don't know how much more of this woman I can take.
Alright, I don't see anything else to look at, so let's head into the training hall and hopefully get Maya. We are not getting Maya.
Oh, shit, February 9th, Inner Temple, training hall.
What the fuck?
What's wrong?
Why is there a psyche lock on the door?
Why are you so quiet?
Maya, she was supposed to be in here training.
Yet, it appears she's nowhere to be seen.
Oh, what's that? A strange lock? It wasn't there 2 days ago. This whole room really is giving off some strange vibes.
Alright, let's investigate the strange vibes.
This door. Where, when I was here 2 days ago, that weird lock wasn't on it.
Those chains. It's almost as if they're guarding something inside that cavern. I've never seen a lock quite like this before.
I have. I have seen locks and chains just like this before. They look just like the ones that guard a person's secrets during Psyche Lock. I wonder if this lock is guarding something too. Dark secrets in a dark cavern? We're about to unleash the Yeti. I can feel it. Look at those wafer-thin mattresses.
I'm sorry, Phoenix Wright. Wafer-thin?
Yeah, you know, thin. Like a wafer. In other words, uncomfortable. That's how we describe things, like these mattresses. I guess you must say wafer thick or something back in Germany.
I'd like to point out we are going to deserve the whipping that we're about to get. Not about these mattresses. Certainly not.
Oh.
I don't know how we
did. Oh, we survived.
We survived.
We survived. Oh, shit. It's an antique dresser.
Don't you dare open it, Phoenix Wright!
Oh. I'm gonna open it.
Okay. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna! Okay. Now I know how Maya feels when I tell her not to touch things.
What a pity. It's full of nothing but old clothes for the acolytes.
I thought we weren't opening it.
No, you aren't opening it. I'm from the prosecutor's office. I can do anything. When in America, yeah. You just do whatever you want and say whatever.
Yeah, you can do anything except stand up to a 9-year-old girl. What?
Yeah, the fact that Nick can't figure out how to stand up to Franziska, despite being a 26-year-old man.
Yeah.
What do you think this yellowish poster is, Phoenix, right?
It's a scroll, not a poster. It's a picture of a woman who's actually...
A woman? I don't see any woman here.
There's a different atmosphere in this room since the last time I was here. Oh no. It's not different atmosphere, it's a different smell!
Please tell me that's not poop. It's gravy! It's
Oh, it's coffee.
Oh, shit.
What's the matter? We were all on very different trains of thoughts there.
The scroll, it's been completely covered in gravy.
Ah, yes. There is a very appetizing smell in the air. But gravy is a type of sauce. So when you run out of paint, you Americans use gravy as a substitute, I see.
Thank God.
No. No one does that. For starters, it thinks. This must be the gravy that we had with the roast on the night of the incident. But why would anyone do this? Why this scroll? In the Japanese version, it was curry sauce.
That's what I figured based on the color.
Yeah.
That was my first instinct.
It what? Seems more like curry, in my opinion. Yeah.
What took you so long? I don't know who this is.
Oh, Jesus.
I thought you and you'd managed to... Oh, hello!
Oh, that is definitely...
Thought even you'd managed to get here faster than this, Mr. Trike. The fuck?
Wow, Prosecutor Godot, you sounded like an 8-year-old girl. I didn't know you were here.
Prosecutor?
How come you didn't show up at the trial today?
You're asking the exact same question.
Huh? But I was... I had a cold, so...
There's something slightly more important than a common cold to deal with. Fuck you.
Yeah.
The importance of which is something you have no hope of ever understanding.
Enough! I believe I have the measure of you. You are the very worst kind of prosecutor. What could be more important than a trial? This is what you get paid for, bitch.
Oh, wow.
Wild mare, Trite. Uh-oh.
Oh, no. We're gonna get whipped.
Okay, Godot has the vibe that I think he would be able to catch the whip if she tried to whip him.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I feel that. Mr. Armando, now we can replace the foolish whip count with the coffee count. This is, Miss Von Karma. She was the acting prosecutor in your absence today.
Well, I guess I owe you one, then. You can go now, princess. Time for the big boys to take the reins. Oh, fucking Christ.
Oh, come
my
on,
God.
Man. Just who do you think you are? This case is my...
Hey, Philly. I honestly, though, I do like the horse puns as opposed to the cat stuff that he was going on with. Anyway,
yeah, agree.
So I will give him, like, a point for that.
A
just because
singular
it's not as creepy.
A singular point.
Singular point. Hey, Philly, know your role and shut your mouth. Can't stand women like you. Wow.
Misery!
Sorry. Getting controversial on screen tonight. Apologize. No. Not only gonna say this once, Lady Von Whippingberg, go home.
Whippingberg.
Phoenix Wright!
What?
Whipped us?
Why are you hitting me for?
You deserve more cracks of the whip than that, Trite. You still don't get it, do you? You don't realize that you've set something in motion that you'll never be able to undo.
There's something different at Puckado today. I don't like it. I'm getting such a strong sense of something from behind that mask of his. Maybe he's a Kamen Rider, I don't know. He could be. Trying to conceal his identity. Is it anger or sorrow?
Because this has been a super fun conversation. Let's continue it.
Right? So super totes fun, guys.
Oh my god, hold on. You had some important business, and that's why you were in court, huh? So, what was it?
I told you once before, but perhaps you don't remember. Returned from the depths of hell to do battle with you.
That's very vague, sir.
Right. I've experienced something most have not. Death.
You died?
Of course. Being extradited from hell is a tedious affair.
What?
He's just being moody.
Feel a bit.
Oh my god. Why? The
meticulous.
Meticulous. Jesus. It's been a long day, y'all. meticulous regeneration and adjustment of all your internal organs is. Well, let's just say modern medicine allows us all to live to a ripe old age.
You had surgery? So, you mean that mask you wear is,
It's not just a fashion piece. Why would you think it was?
I mean, you never know.
Peter Christ, I lost. this ugly device, I promise, it's not a fashion statement, my unenlightened friend.
I mean, what was the thought process there? He looked at a toaster and went, you know what that would be great for? Glasses.
I'm pretty sure that's what whoever did this character design was thinking, but not the dough. Without this, I can't see your freaking frequently dumbfounded face.
I didn't know.
My eyesight is pretty messed up. Even with these huge goggles on my head, I still can't see everything. And I still keep this worn out piece of junk of a body going with regular service.
I'm sorry, but you say you experienced death? How is that possible? What happened?
Backstory.
Why don't you ask him?
Huh? Me?
Yeah, Trite, you. You should know all about it. You know when my life ended, and who ended it for me.
Well, Phoenix Wright, do you?
Nobody, I don't know what he's talking about. Although, to be honest, I do feel a little tug at the corner of my memory. I think I do know about how Godot was killed.
Okay, hold on. A quick pause. Mm-hmm. Is this just, do we actually not know, or am I just not remembering what happened?
It has, I think it's mentioned very, very, very briefly in the first case, but no.
Okay.
It has not, we have not done a deep dive into this. We do not know necessarily, because we don't even know. Okay. Phoenix right. doesn't technically even know who Godot is. We happen to know that he's Diego Armando, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. There's just some times where it's like, because I have memory problems, so it's like, is it just my brain being stupid, or do I not actually
know? Yeah, you don't actually know this. You can possibly piece it together, but again, we played the first case so long ago that I would be very surprised if you remembered any of the like weird one-line details from it.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. It will all become clear in due time. Isn't that right, Trite? It rhymes.
Yeah. Earlier you said you'd done something I can never undo. What did you mean by that exactly?
Peter Temple here on this side of Dusky Bridge is an isolated island.
That's what Sister Bikini said, too. And I... Oh, wait, that's it.
Oh, thank you. Do you know what the police are doing here today?
What do you mean?
They're searching. Searching for any trace of an acolyte who went missing.
Maya?
Missing?
Maya, where you going?
As leader of the search party, I can tell you with this absolute certainty, this with them. Maya Faye is not on this side of Dusky Bridge.
Huh? But that's impossible. She came here that night and...
I won't say it again. The chances of her being here are nil. Including, of course, one very unique place.
One? Where's that?
The Sacred Cavern. The entrance of which we are standing at right now. Right meow.
Right meow.
I don't know why my brain just every time I say like right now, my brain immediately just in my like just right now. This is the only place that the search party has yet to explore. Is this fact?
So they haven't searched that cavern yet, huh?
Be aware though that the temperature inside frequently falls below freezing. We're gonna find a Maya icicle. A Maya popsicle.
Mycicle?
even if she were in there, the chances of her being found alive are slim at best.
No!
Which means, Trite, that you sent Maya Faye to her death. It did not!
You fool! If that's the situation, why aren't you in there with a search party right now?
I was in the hospital! God damn it!
Over on the bench! you must have blinders on, my equestrian angel.
Oh okay, my god.
Equestrian angel.
A big walking James.
I just was Godot a horse girl as a kid? Like what the fuck, okay. Man?
Godot just got one look at Francesca and said horse girl energy.
He's a brony, no.
I will sort of say that in one of the future games you get to see Francesca as she's not like a child, but she is fairly young. It's before 13, so she's not quite an attorney yet. And instead of a whip, she has a little writing crop that she keeps hitting Edgeworth with. It's very cute.
He's a brony. Oh no. He's a brony.
It's a trick lock. I am making preparations to open it as we speak. Well, trite. Again? Woman dies because of you.
What? Once again? What are you talking about?
Don't tell me you've forgotten. Only 2 years ago, after all. Oh. When the last unfortunate woman died because of you.
Because of me.
And don't you know who that was? It was Maya Faye's sister. That's right, Mia Faye. She didn't die because
no.
Mia.
You killed her.
But no! That's not how it was!
It was 2 years ago. Mia Faye was pursuing someone. A man. But she bit off more than she could chew. She made a very dangerous enemy.
Yeah, that's one case I'll never forget. But I got that guy, personally!
Sure. Miss Faye's murderer was caught. But that won't bring her back.
Well, no, but...
You were with her at the time. And no one... You and no one else. It was your responsibility. You should have protected her. You say Mia Faye was your teacher. Well then, I'd say you learned nothing, Trite. You robbed her of her life, and now, you've let her sister suffer the same fate.
This is such a nice conversation.
I haven't sentenced Maya to death. No!
What is this peculiar looking lock? Yes, yes, I understand you guys are having this very deep emotional conversation. I don't care. What's the damn lock? Why don't we just break it open? It would be a simple matter of...
I'm afraid we can't do that. This area has always been prone to earthquakes. The repeated tremors have weakened the foundations of the training hall. Any excessive force used to break the lock open would... Well, let's just say the inner temple in the sacred cavern would be a thing of the past.
Can we not just use bolt cutters on the chain?
Mm-hmm.
Very well. Then dare I suggest the obvious solution of opening it with the key?
Sure, just show me where the keyhole is on the trick lock. See it.
There's no keyhole? There's a Magatama-shaped thing over there looking
good. That's what it's like. I see something. That's right. An interesting puzzle, huh? The person who set this lock is the only one who could open it.
Then who was it?
Obviously, we gotta write our name on it or something, you know?
Simple. The accused.
What? Iris?
When an acolyte undergoes training inside the sacred cavern, the attending sister is responsible for locking the entrance.
It seems like a bad idea considering the fact that it gets below freezing in there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Why would you want to lock them in? Is a normal lock not enough?
Obviously, the night of the murder was no exception. Maya Faye was trained there.
Sister Bikini did mention it a number of times now that I think about it. He said that Iris was left in charge of supervising the early stages of the training.
So Iris, the accused, is the only one who could open this lock.
For me?
I prayed for her to be brought here now.
Iris is the only person who can open the lock? I hope she gets here soon. Hang on in there, Maya. We'll get you out.
Maverick, you're okay, buddy. So, I should be getting back to work.
Wait, Godot. How sure about Maya are you?
There's no doubt in my mind. She's in the sacred cavern somewhere. The only place she could be. Except for she won't be. You better start praying. You better pray that friend of yours brings the accused back here soon.
Edgeworth?
My first instinct was Larry, and I sat there and went, why would you let Larry escort her?
That's my first instinct was dumb too. You know. Listen up, Trite. There's only one thing I want to say to you before I go. I'll never accept you. Never. Jesus.
Okay.
You should choose your friends more carefully, Phoenix Wright.
That's what everyone says. It looks like I don't have much of a choice. Guess I'll just have to do what I can do for now.
Alright, well.
Can we put the Mogatomers in thing?
No.
Shit.
I think that's an external, it's like jutting out, not in.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah. I don't know, should I or shouldn't I?
Sounds like someone's talking to himself, but where's that coming from?
Yeah. I guess I better wash that off. That's what I'll do. No, but I can't do that! I'm a detective! Ugh! My brain! This is driving me nuts! Ah! Is something troubling you, Scruffy? But please don't whip me like that all of a sudden, sir! It was merely a simple greeting. A friendly tap on the shoulder. With my whip.
No. So, what's up, Gumshoe? Is something on your mind?
How did you know, pal? Perhaps you were trying to decide if you wanted to wash that off or not? How did you know, sir? Oh, yeah! I nearly forgot. You can't go through that little gate there, okay?
You mean the one that says no entry on it?
I'm with Francisca, we should have just went through, but... kind of already snuck in there.
Is he trying to be clever or something?
So, what's behind there, Scruffy? Huh? Kind of like a garden, like garden.
A garden?
Yeah. Anyway, it's under investigation right now, so keep out. I'm not telling you. I'm asking you, pal. You got me?
Isn't it normally the other way around?
Well, see you later.
Okay. Gonna make good choices.
So, shall we adjourn to this garden, Phoenix Wright?
Of course. What else would we do? I really want to know what Gumshoe was thinking of washing off.
Alright, let's go to the garden.
Was it gravy again?
Uh-oh.
February 9th, Inner Temple Garden.
There's a strange feeling in the air. I wonder what it is.
Strange feeling? Forget about that. What's that strange writing on the stone lantern?
What are you doing here, sir? I thought I said you can't come in here! Don't you know, Scruffy? A Von Karma will always show up wherever there is a clue. Also, you told me no, so I'm going to go in there immediately. And there are plenty of clues to be found here. But...
You're growing so much weed in this garden, pal. So how's the inter-temple investigation going?
We have the best forensic team in the world working the place. Forensic team? And what was the outcome of this scientific study? Nothing! Scientifically speaking, this place is as clean as a whistle. That's simply not good enough, Scruffy. Do you think I'll let you get away with that? Uh-oh. Well, there were a couple of things that bothered me when I first got here, sir.
That stone lantern, and the surrounding area that's not covered in snow, correct?
They look kind of fishy to me, you know, scientifically speaking.
Scientifically speaking, of course.
So, I got the lab boys to look them over. The results were... It's kind of hard to say, actually.
I guess I better look into them myself. We have to bring Emma Sky in. About my,
Did Mr. Godot tell you yet?
Yes, we heard.
He's got a search party out looking for her, but there's nowhere else she could have disappeared to on this side of Dusky Bridge. All we can do is wait for Mr. Edgeworth to get here, pal.
Edgeworth?
He's escorting Iris, the defendant over here.
We'll have to wait, since she is the only one who can open the door to the sacred cavern.
Oh, I think Mr. Edgeworth wants to talk to you about something too, pal.
Uh-huh. I wonder what it is.
Just don't be expecting any good news when you talk to him. When I spoke to him, Mr. Edgeworth sounded so down, I felt like I was drowning.
Sounds pleasant.
Anyway, let's take a look around.
Oh no! That looks sus. Little lantern, little statue.
It is certainly a quaint little garden. Oh! What is this huge bowl here for?
Oh, I know this one. It's a water bowl, isn't it?
Everything else is completely frozen over, but the ice in this bowl has been broken.
That's true. I wonder if this has any impact on the case.
I doused my face earlier with the water in this. I was getting kind of sleepy.
Next time you're sleepy, you need only come to me! Got it? Don't disrupt the damn crime scene.
Maybe.
There's a charm or something poking out from the snow. Looks pretty old. There's a leather cord tied to it, too.
Apparently, it belonged to the victim.
To Miss Elise Donim?
Yeah, there was a broken leather cord around the lady's neck. The ends of the cords found on both the victim and this charm match exactly.
Sounds to me like... this little trinket is going to be my ticket to getting some very big answers.
Alright, we have the Kurain Master's Talisman. Which now tells us that Ms. Elise Donim may have been the Kurain Master!
There's a couple of torches here! I guess you need all the light you can get up here in the mountains.
Yeah, I was looking at those things, pal. It looks like they've been lit pretty recently.
Recently? How recent are we talking about?
As recent as the night of the murder.
Maybe I was training here on the night of the murder. It's not unreasonable to think that these things were lit up at the time, I guess. What the heck is that?
Uh-oh. You spotted it, huh, pal?
Are you kidding me? Couldn't be more obvious.
It says... Maya.
Yeah. And before you ask, it's written in blood.
Oh,
You will answer all of our questions now, Scruffy, without exception. Yes, sir.
82.
Well, this is odd. There's no snow on the ground here. And it's almost perfectly rectangled. It could have had happened. It couldn't have happened naturally.
Yes. It appears as though someone has carefully cleared away the snow. No doubt it was you, wasn't it, Scruffy?
Huh? No, it wasn't me, sir. It was already like that when my men and I got here to start the investigation.
If it wasn't the police, then who did it?
Oh, yeah. There's something I need to tell you. Just between the three of us, okay?
What is it?
It's top secret. You can't tell anyone, got it?
I'm gonna tell everybody.
Understood.
Mm-hmm. Well, when I was a kid, I got knocked out of the local wrestling contest, you see. I was so disappointed, I just picked up my mouth guard and cried all the way home. Man, I got in so much trouble when I left it on the couch. He's gonna die.
Yeah.
Is that it?
That's it.
Ugh! One. Whoever cleared the snow away must have had a reason. 84! Although I can't even begin to imagine what the reason could be.
I don't see anything else to take a look at. Alright. Let's start asking him about the bloody writing.
Maya, so these letters are written in blood.
Yeah. What's worse is it's the victim's blood.
Huh? This is Miss Donim's blood?
We haven't done a detailed analysis yet, but it's looking that way, pal.
Most interesting. Phoenix Wright. I presume you know, don't you? Why Maya's name is written upside down?
At least Donim wrote it as she was flying away.
You know what? That was really bothering me too. But I just came up with the answer. The result of my own special gumshoe investigation. Really? Do tell. Well, on the night of the murder, that stone lantern was upside down.
What? Oh, buddy.
Ahem. Anyway, there's really only one logical explanation to this mystery. Miss Elise Donim wrote these letters herself in her own blood.
You must be joking. That's impossible.
From the writing in the victim's blood and the other clues left behind, it seems pretty likely that this garden was the scene of Miss Elise Donim's murder. At least, that's our current theory on how the events took place, pal.
What? So Miss Donim was killed here.
However you want to look at it, that's what people are saying now.
And what Sister Bikini saw in the courtyard at the main temple was... Well, what was it? If that wasn't the scene of the crime, what did she see?
What do you think, Miss Von Karma?
Surely a special gumshoe investigation would reveal the answer, no?
85. But wait a sec. The bloody writing and all the other clues here. Someone could have easily set all that up after the murder, right?
Oh, that's me, sorry. Sorry, but that's not an option, pal.
Why not?
How quickly you forget, Phoenix Wright. Ever since the incident occurred, this place has been completely inaccessible. Inaccessible, that's a really hard word.
It is.
Because Dusky Bridge was completely burned out. Have you forgotten what you fell off of?
I was overseeing repairs to the bridge the whole time. No one came over here before me and my men. Which means no one could have planted all this stuff here, pal.
I can't think of a counter argument to that.
Oh, I knew it. I should have washed the blood off the lantern as soon as I got here. No, that is interfering with a crime scene.
No.
Yeah, that's not cool, buddy.
If this really was the scene of the crime, then I need to figure out exactly what it was that Bikini actually saw.
Alright. I guess we go talk to Bikini. Because she's always been real fun to talk to. Okay, suspension bridge.
Always so honest and not hiding anything. Pretty nice, how's it crumbling gate?
It seems you have a visitor.
Oh, I forgot I was meeting Mr. Wright.
Iris. I'm glad to see you. Godot managed to mobilize the police by claiming a state of emergency.
Not him again.
Never mind him. We've gotta hurry and unlock the sacred cavern, if people forgot.
I'm sorry, Miss Wright. It's my fault someone so important to you is locked in there. Mr. Edward, can we finish our conversation later?
All right.
Which
let's hurry to the let's hurry to the inner temple then. I'll see you later, right? Because I'm the only one getting shit done here. Hold it. Wait, Edgeworth. I'm coming with you guys. Oh, sorry, Riot. I can't allow you to come with us. You're not invited. What?
I mean, it's fair if they think that they're going to find a dead body.
Yeah.
That they don't invite Phoenix to go, considering who she is to him. Like, it does make sense.
I hate to be the one to break it to you, but Maya Fey is in a rather delicate position. What do you mean by delicate position? This isn't simply a rescue operation, right? It's also an investigation.
Yeah, because if you look at the crime scene, or what they think is the crime scene now, if she's alive, she's now possibly going to be accused of murder. So that's going to be real good.
Yeah.
That being the case, we can't allow members of the public to interfere. Come on, Edgeworth. If anything happens, you'll be the first to know. Please understand, right? But Maya!
Mr. Wright. All that matters is that Mystic Maya is rescued, correct?
I...
Listen to the voice of reason for a change, Phoenix Wright.
From now on, consider anything beyond Dusky Bridge to be off limits. We'll be going now. Excuse us.
Oh, buddy.
Hey, Maverick.
Ah!
I know.
This is no time to be standing around, Phoenix Wright. Aren't there other things to demand your attention?
She's right. Thanks for reminding me. Wow, Edgy cares about her feelings. February 9th has a current temple, what a babe, main hall.
I mean, I'd like to point out, I think the more surprising one is that Francisca cares about our feelings.
Yeah, right? That was surprising. Mr. Bikini looks like she's shrunk some since I last saw her. And that's saying something, since she couldn't even reach the podium.
Don't be so rude, Phoenix Wright. What's wrong, Sister Bikini?
Bye, bye, bye. Hello, you two. How are you doing?
From the sound of that sigh, I guess she's still pretty down.
Iris is just here, you know. Well, she was accompanied by that handsome crimson-clad prince.
Ew.
Thanks, Ben. Okay. she talking about Edgeworth?
A courtesy call. I wasn't allowed to talk with her at all. Oh dear, it's all my fault that this has happened. Poor Iris. She was worried about my back, would you believe? What have I done to her?
Only what you had to do, sister. You bravely and truthfully testified about what you saw. There's no shame in that. And we'll see to it that your testimony wasn't made in vain.
Well, I don't hear anyone else saying that. Mr. Blue Suits doesn't seem to share your opinion, I see.
That's Mystic Phoenix to you.
Yeah, I'm Mr. Phoenix. Ah! Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, you did great, Sister Bikini. Ah! Absolutely spectacular!
You were the only ones who said that to me.
I can't shake off the feeling that I just became a shill to a shrew.
Do you have a problem, Phoenix Wright?
Sure, she was brave to testify so truthfully like that. But I know she's still hiding something. Guess it's time to break those psyche locks of hers. But do I want to do that in front of, Francisca?
Why not? She already thinks we're crazy, it's fine.
Yeah, it's fine. Hmm. Truth is becoming increasingly clear to me. Oh yeah, I'm gonna convince. Yeah, special significance to the temple. Yeah, so I believe this has to do with her true identity.
Who is she?
What are you talking about?
We're paraphrasing. It's getting late.
Yeah, I'm fading, and I know that I'm losing traction with Mav, so.
So, this piece of evidence proves her identity. We now have the talisman.
Miss O'Nim had this charm with her at all times.
Arg! Where did you...
What's a carg? This isn't some cheap good luck charm either.
I'd like to point out she has the weirdest size, so...
She does.
Yeah. And then... What do you think it is, Mr. Rowe? What could a talisman like that possibly mean?
It's a talisman, isn't it? Interesting.
Oops.
This thing speaks volumes about who Ms. Donim really was. The talisman and one other item unequivocally prove that Ms. Donim's true identity.
We're gonna go with the hanging scroll because it's got the mark of the master on it.
The painting is obscured by gravy stain in the moment, but this scroll shows the master of the Karain channeling technique. The crest at the top is a sign of an honorable title. The very same crest that adorns the talisman the victim carried with her. Crest is reserved for the master of Karain.
Who on earth told you that nonsense? I've got no idea what you're talking about.
Well, it happened to be her daughter.
The new master, Maya Faye, told me.
What? You mean that acolyte is Misty Faye's...
daughter? Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes, In fact, since her eldest daughter passed away, Maya is Misty Faith's sole successor.
Mystic Misty.
Well, that was easy.
Oh, whoa. Okay.
Woo! We did it!
We did it! But oh no, Maya's mom is dead!
Yeah.
Mystic Elise graced us with her presence about a week ago. When she showed me the talisman with the mark on it, well, I nearly fainted. No one had seen her since she disappeared 17 years ago, after all.
What is the significance of this talisman, sister?
The Kurain talisman? It's a symbol of the Master of Kurain. The bearer must carry it with them until their death.
Until their death?
So, Elise Dunham really was Maya's mother, huh?
She was Misty Fae, the master of the Kurain channeling technique.
Truth comes out at last. It looks like we're making some headway here.
Tell me, sister. After 17 years, why did she choose to show herself now?
Because something happened that called her out of hiding.
What happened?
Well.
Uh-oh. What's happening?
An earthquake.
It can't be.
Edward's gonna lose his mind.
Yeah, but hopefully Maya's okay in that chamber.
Yeah. Earthquake!
Ah!
Oh my goodness, the inner temple, it's kind of... this kind of tremor might.
The inner temple?
The sacred cavern in the training hall. It might very well cave in.
What? Maya!
It seems to have passed.
We can't just stand here and do nothing. Let's go!
What? Where?
The inner temple, of course. Where else? Mr. Bikini, we'll finish this later, all right?
Of course. You run along now. People may have been hurt. I must get some first aid kits ready.
Come on then, Phoenix Wright! They won't bar you from entering as long as I'm with you.
Thank you? I don't know why I'm like... Damn, okay, right at the moment I had the worst feeling in my gut. We just had an earthquake. I wonder if he's alright.
He is not alright, it's fine.
You look worried.
Oh, no.
Are you thinking about Miles Edgeworth?
My boyfriend? My ex? I mean, come on, let's go.
Alright, we can stop here, or we can see if Maya's okay.
Honestly, I hate to do this to you guys, but I think we need to stop here because my dog is about to lose his goddamn mind.
That's fine, that's kind of what I figured. Alright, so, next stream...
Oh, a solid click finger.
Next stream is probably Sunday. Just as a heads up, I am getting my COVID booster tomorrow, so if I'm not feeling great by Sunday, we may cancel. Or if we need time, you know, we may cancel. Sundays are always a little iffy. So if no one has any announcements, we'll wrap up.
Yeah,
sounds good.
All right. So wash your hands, wear a mask. Please get vaccinated, get your booster shots, and we will see you guys next time we see you. Have a good night, all.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.